Okay, so before we actually start, I want to quickly make absolutely clear that this is not a joke. This is not a goof. I am actually talking about a fucking railway management game today. That's actually where I am in my life. I'm actually going to be sitting here and telling you, ladies and gentlemen at home, about a game that I've spent 5 hours playing, in which you run a railway company in the 1800s. I am embarrassed about who I am because I am literally a dad who doesn't have any children. Alright, dickheads, I'm your chunky, unless you count Lara, but she's not actually my child, she's my best friend who acts like a child. Alright, dickheads, I'm your chunky messiah, Ethan, and I'm just here with a bit of an old impressions, and impressions of a game that came out a bit ago. This is not particularly relevant, no one's gonna watch this. This game came out, I think, in either October or November. It's not a new game, because, you know, as we all know, gaming moves incredibly fucking quickly these days. But here we are. This, in case you're not aware, because good lord, why would you be, is Railway Corporation. A game published, I believe, by Iceberg Interactive and developed by a company called Corby Games. I believe that's correct. And it's a game in which you run a railway corporation in the 1800s. It's like it's like a management game. It's, yeah, that I can't think of any better way to describe it. It's a railway management game set in the 1800s. Essentially, the game has two modes that I could see. Two modes that caught my attention. There's definitely more than that. Hang on. Let's go to the menu and quickly check, because Ethan's dumb. Let's quickly double check how many modes this game actually has. 3. Because you got your campaign, your multiplayer, and your free game. What the how could you compete in that? Alright, okay, I guess, sure. But yes, it's a game in which you are running a railway corporation. Ultimately, the goal of the game, depending on which mode you're playing, if it's in free play, my assumption, I haven't touched that because I played 5 hours of it and I've only done 2 campaign missions because I'm slow and bad at it. Because yes, I'm both playing a boring game, enjoying it, and being terrible at it. It's like this great like trifecta of ludicrous things. But yeah, I am also very aware that every time I speak, I seem to be peeking the microphone. So I'm gonna try and keep my face back here until I can fix that after this video. But yeah, ultimately, if you're in your free play mode, the aim of the game is to attempt to make as much money as possible. If you are playing the campaign mode, as I am, your aim is to, well, fulfill the objectives here. This is the second mission of the campaign, or at least, the second mission that isn't a tutorial of the campaign. And our goal right now is essentially to connect all these settlements, all these towns and places in such a way as to be producing clothing, which we must then sell in Atlanta, and by doing so, we will complete the level. The game is essentially a matter of slowly attempting to expand out from your central place, making upgrades, maintaining your trains, all that kind of jazz. We'll just start doing that as we're talking. The game does, I'm trying to think what the easiest way to make some money is. Let's just quickly check. How much does that cost? If I can actually get it to connect. Come on. That's 26. What about you? 28. Okay, it's actually cheaper to transport coal. Okay. And we actually start with a train, so we will get this fella transporting coal to Knoxville for us. And then that, yeah, that train will just start going back and forth, buying coal there, selling it in Knoxville. Okay, cool. But yeah, so that's ultimately the goal of the game. The game does have some options before you actually get into the campaign. I don't know, I assume that these were also, I would assume there'd be some kind of customization to this nature in the free play mode. I'm not a reviewer, you know this. I'm not professional at all. I'm a fuckwit. But in the, just fucking while I remember. Oh no, we can't. Ah, well. But yes, as I'm sure... Fuck, I've completely lost my train of thought. My train of thought. Haha! So I just need to blow that up there because I need this over here. And then... I've done the wrong one again, haven't I? Yep, sounds like me. That really, really does sound like me. I'll give you that one. Yeah, that's like really unnecessarily expensive, what I just did there. Really way more expensive than that needed to be, but oh well, that's the situation we're in now. This is the new paradigm that we're functioning in. But yes, we were in the campaign, you do actually pick one of, I seem to recall it was three separate railway companies to be part of, each of which offers you basically a different starting bonus on each level, a different kind of benefit. For the choice. I decided to go with the Kane Eastern Railway because that gives me a starter train at the beginning of every level, so I don't need to immediately invest in a train. Annoyingly, it is just the shittiest form of train you can get, which I believe it's called the Best Friend, isn't it? Hang on, let me check. It is called the Best Friend. Yeah, the Best Friend, which is awful. I currently have the John Bull unlocked, which is a better one. I just need to wait until I make enough money to actually take advantage of that fellow. Ultimately, the game is one of attempting to essentially it's very basic supply and demand stuff with basically that relies more or less on you not being an idiot in terms of your track placement. That's more or less the issue. The greatest challenge the game presents is essentially managing to keep your lines profitable because, you know, if you sell too much of one resource in one place, that place will no longer use it. Or that oil will no longer be able to sell it there. So it's essentially attempting to maintain and adapt to the changing economic system, situation in the area, while building lines that are actually going to be profitable by selling your stuff from place to place. And at the same time, avoiding expanding too quickly, because ultimately this game does have one direct failure state that I've noticed, that direct failure state being, yeah, you see they're hitting your maximum overdraft of $50,000. That's the only way that I've seen that this game will just give you a flat-out game over, and yeah, that can happen. That does actually happen alarmingly quickly. This is a game a bit like Banished, in that it genuinely just kind of goes from 0 to 100 in terms of how fucked you are. Like, you genuinely just go from everything is absolutely and perfectly fine to a complete economic collapse in moments just because one thing went wrong. The biggest danger I've seen in this game, while I've been playing it, the thing that's caused me a game over multiple times is essentially expanding too quickly and relying on that overdraft to, oh good, no, that's great. Yeah, no, that's fine. I mean, that's not literally not going to cause any problems. It's just that looks fucking stupid. But yeah, the biggest problem is honestly just expanding too quickly. That's your biggest threat in this game, because you expand too quickly and then you collapse. Like, everything just falls apart if you expand too quickly. There we go. Yeah, because then basically you can get into a situation where while even if the line that you've expanded to make is profitable, it will take a bit for that profit to actually come in and you will just be losing money for a short time, which can be something of a bother. Can be a bit of a ball-like. Fuck it, we'll buy the John Ball. Just because otherwise we will just be sat here doing nothing. And then unload in Knoxville. And ideally, that should go on the other track. Yeah. The game is, I will say, not exactly the most polished thing in the world. As you can probably tell, graphically, it's nothing impressive. There's nothing. It honestly looks quite old. It's got this vague look of a board game to it. It's also, for a genre that one would expect to be quite detailed and involved, as a, like, railway management game, it honestly doesn't seem to be. It may just be the early stage that I'm at, but there's honestly not very much to it, and it is quite a repetitive experience. I've been enjoying it as something I can listen to podcasts while I'm playing, because it is, you know, it's shit moving on a screen with some occasional decision-making in order to attempt to basically figure out how to position things, where to put your trains, what lines to be using, all that jazz. But other than that, yeah, it's not the most impressive game in the world. It has quite a few issues. I've not run into any overt bugs in the 5 hours I've played of it. I have, however, run into just some oddities, some frustrating oddities that this game is quite subject to. One of which we aren't seeing here, but one of which always drives me up the wall is, you can see here, actually you can see it when I needed to delete this entire stretch of track, or the original stretch of track that went to Murphy, is that essentially, I highlight this here, this is one huge stretch of track. There can only be one train on this track at any given time, and there doesn't appear to be any way to change that, and the game doesn't seem to care about whether or not the trains are going in the same direction. There can always only be one section, only one train on each section of track, but the sections of track are essentially an arbitrary measurement, because, as you can see here, this entire length from Knoxville to, I can't even remember what this is called, Cookville. Yeah, we can only have one train on here, even if they're both going in the same direction to the same place. There can only be one train. And literally, if I tried to send another train on this track from Knoxville... Oh, no, let's say right now I wanted to send another train from Cookville to Knoxville, and I had a train here. The train here will wait until this one has completely finished the route before even setting off, and that'll lock this one, T2 over here, in Knoxville until it's arrived, rather than just letting the other train follow behind. Meanwhile, because this one is essentially built into three sections, three discrete clicks, I can have one train on this bit of line, one train on this bit of line, and then one train on this longer bit of line, as long as they're all going in the same direction, and it's no issue. It's a deeply frustrating thing. Not helped by the fact that the decision-making, I suppose, I want to say AI, but that doesn't seem appropriate, but the decision-making behind which track the trains go on doesn't seem to take into account other trains. Because I generally wouldn't upgrade this track this early, station this early, you know, to unlock the double, the two tracks, the two tracks going in and out. Normally, I wouldn't have done that yet. Normally, what I would have done is, in fact, what I did the last time I played this level was I essentially had one track come out here and then split off in two directions. One going to Murphy, one going to Cooksville. However, I quickly realized that simply doesn't work because of the same issue where, yeah, one train will just arbitrarily wait. Like, literally, let's say that these two tracks are attached here. One of the trains could get here, and it will then one train could get there, and would then stop, because this train from all the way over here came out first. So then this train that is like a couple of feet, essentially, from the station, has to wait for the train that's miles away to get there, because this one technically left first, even though this one's a lot closer. Again, because this is one long stretch of track. And you also have, again, the issue where you could literally have two tracks coming out, where one track comes here, it splits off into two directions. Say one train needs to go to Cookville, the other one needs to take a rail round to Chattanooga, and I've physically built a rail round to Chattanooga. Yeah, no, it will just try to go through Cooksville, even if there is a specific route. It won't fucking follow it. the decision making behind the trains in this game is very frustrating and not particularly efficient, and also not particularly customizable, which is honestly, based on the other reviews I've seen of this game on the Steam store page, a frustration. Playing this game, I have been enjoying it, but I have become increasingly aware that this is not the best version of this game that there is. There is literally, I think that there are better, essentially better games doing the same thing that also look nicer as well, that are currently available. I don't know how much more complicated or how much more difficult to get into those ones are. I'll give this game that for, honestly, something that I expected to be as unforthcoming, as unhelpful of a genre as a railway company simulator, a railway management game. This game is a fairly simple one to understand. It wouldn't surprise me if the essentially better examples of this genre that exist currently. In fact, there was literally, I think, I haven't played it, but from the looks of it, there's one called Railway Empire that came out literally last year, which is, from what I can tell, a better version of this game. But it wouldn't surprise me if that one is also just a lot more complicated and a lot more difficult to get into, because this one is immediately, you know, once you more or less figure out the UI, this is an immediately understandable game, and there's not much that's really hidden. Like, literally, what you're seeing here is it. You know what I mean? Like, this is it. Like, these menus are all the game is. That's it. It's not gonna get any more elaborate than this. There is a bit of kind of optimization of kind of the supply chain of like getting the more expensive goods, you know, the manufactured goods. Like, you can buy factories and warehouses and stuff essentially to lower the price of the raw materials and to lower the price of the creation of clothes and the such, like, you know, a big upfront cost to kind of mitigate the expenses of getting the goods yourself. But yeah, it's fine. This is a short video. I just kind of wanted to get this out of the way. It's fine. Railway Corporation is fine. It's not the best example of what it is. However, if you can get it in a sale and you, like, haven't played this kind of game before and you want to see if it's for you, if you can get this in a sale, I can recommend that. If I had bought this, full price, I don't think I'd be happy with it. But given that I basically randomly got review code for it a bit after its release, I had a decent amount of fun. I want to try Railway Empire though, because this is not the height of this genre, and I am kind of interested in seeing a more elaborate take on this genre, because this is kind of simple and frustrating in the lack of customization of certain things. And also, again, like, I have the Kane Eastern Railway, because your research does actually, like, keep between each campaign level, and the fact that the Kane Eastern Railway does just start you off with, like, its bonus is immediately useless the second you unlock the second type of train, because you're getting the objectively worst kind of train, and seems to be, you will always get the worst kind of train, so you'll basically be immediately replacing it. So it's like a weird waste. That seems odd. If I'd made this, that bonus would give you the best kind of train you have researched at the beginning of the map, rather than the very earliest form. That's a bit of a peculiar one. There will be a link in the description to where you can pick this up on Steam if you're interested. Sorry for making you sit through this one. Bye. I don't think I've ever apologized for a video while I'm making it. Okay, bye. Well, I hope you enjoyed that. I might not have, but then that's kind of irrelevant. I'd make the stuff, not watch it. Anyway, big thanks to the names that are and have been scrolling across the screen. Their donations to my Patreon campaign are a huge help to me and the channel. If you'd also like to have your name listed here, follow the link in the description to find my Patreon page. There are rewards and such. Down there you'll also find links to my Twitter, Twitch, and the channel's Discord server. Stuff often occurs in one or indeed all of those places, so go have a look. And if you want more content, I upload basically a video a day. Right, I'm out of time. Bye.